hygiene's principle. According to hygiene's principle, each point of the wavefront is a source of a secondary disturbance producing wavelets. The wavelets originating from these points spread out in all directions with the speed of the wave. These wavelets originating from the wavefront are usually referred to as secondary wavelets. The tangents to the secondary wavelets give rise to secondary wavefront. Now let us discuss how to construct secondary wavefront. As shown in the picture, here F1, F2, it is the spherical wavefront. Draw spheres of radius V tau. This is the sphere of radius V tau from each point of the spherical wavefront. Here, 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 like this. So these are the spheres of radius V tau. Now, here V is the speed of the wave in the medium. And now draw common tangent to all these spheres. This is the common tangent to all these spheres. That is the G1, G2. So these, the new wavefront G1, G2 is called the secondary wavefront. This G1, G2, this is called the secondary wavefront. And the new wavefront G1, G2 is again spherical with point O as the center. And this model has one shortcoming or drawback. You see, you also have a backward wavefront. This wavefront D1, D2, which is called a backward wavefront. And according to hygiene, the amplitude of the secondary wavelet is maximum in the forward direction and zero in the backward direction. That is why there is no back wave D1, D2. But this assumption is not satisfactory. And in this picture, you see the hygiene's geometrical construction for a plane wave propagating to the right F1, F2. This is the plane wavefront and this is the spherical wavefront.